In this video, I want to talk a little bit about the tool library that is now available on the Hurco lathe product. Version 11 came out here very recently, and we now are able to offer a library on the machine. So when you create a tool, that tool stays with the machine and is able to be used on any program going forward. Previous to that, if you're a lathe user, you already know this, but when we created a new conversational program, there were no tools in the program. I had to import those in from another program or recreate those. So I'm going to show you how we can use the tool library, how that will benefit us and how it works. And then I'm going to turn that option off and then show you how we do it without the tool library, just for reference, so you can see how the differences are. So if I go to my input screen and hit tool review, you'll see that I have 12 different tools in this particular library, and they're all associated with the stations on the turret. And if I go here and create a new program, so I'll go to Input, Program Manager, New, Create HLT Program. I have a new no-name program. If I go back and look at my tool review, you can see that all of those tools are available. If I didn't have the library, that wouldn't be the case. I would now have no tools. I would have to then somehow populate all of these tools in the new program. So I'm going to go here into my options, system configuration, system options, and I'm going to disable the tool library. The system has to reboot to do that, so I'm going to go ahead and reboot and then come back after I've rebooted the software and show you how this would behave without the library. All right, we're back. The software is rebooted. I've turned off the library, so now we can open a program or look at a program that's already open with tools in it. I'll create a new program to show you how those tools are not there, and then a couple of things we can do if you don't have the library just to make things a little easier. So if I go to the program that I have open and I look at the tool review, I have some tools that are in this program that are described. We have some turning tools, boring tool, and threading tools, and so forth about every other station. If I go to the program manager and I create a new HLT program, so another conversational lathe program, and I go to my tool review, you'll see that there are no tools that have come over. There's no descriptions, there's no data of any kind. So the way I would get around that is I would go to the program that has the tools that I want in it. I would highlight it, make sure that's the active program. I'm then going to go to tool review, click on tool number one, come all the way down here and click on the last tool, multiple block functions, copy. Now we're going to go back to the original program, or the new program, go to tool review, and we're just going to do a paste. And that's going to paste all the information in. I didn't get tool 12, it looks like, but it's going to paste in all the information from that old program into the new program. The geometry offsets will already be good to go. So this part now, once I pick up my part zero and have written my program, I should be able to use these and go ahead and run the program. The other way that we see people do this is, let's go to that original program. Let's go to the review screen, which is going to show me all the blocks in the program. And quite often what people will do, especially if they want to keep their part set up and all the tool information, is they'll just go in here and delete all of the blocks in the program, save this program as a new name, and then write the program, put the blocks in it, and so forth. That way we're keeping all of the tools that we've described. We've got our part set up. Anything, our program parameters, everything will be just as it was in the program we just ran, and I don't have to recreate any of that in the new part program. Again, so there's two different ways that you can handle your tool information in version 11. We can do it the old standby way, which I just showed you here without the library, or the library is an option that you could purchase, add to your machine if you think you see some benefit in it, and you would then have that ability and a little bit quicker way to move from part to part.